In this video, I'm going to show you how to set up an FTP server on your computer so you can access files from outside of your local network. To get this running, I will need to set up a dynamic DNS, open up ports in my Windows firewall, open up ports in my router, and install FileZilla Server. The first step is to create a hostname. This hostname is attached to your public IP address, which changes periodically. This will eliminate the need to reconfigure the server each time your public IP changes. I used noip.com, but you can use whichever one you're comfortable with. The next step is to open up Windows Defender Firewall with advanced settings and open up ports 21, 2121, 50,000 to 51,000. Hit next and allow the connection, leave these checked, and name it accordingly. Hit finish and that's it. Next, you will have to open up ports on your router. Internally, I opened up ports 21 and 50,000 to 51,000. Externally, I opened up 2121 and 50,000 to 51,000. 21 is used to log in and send commands, and 50,000 to 51,000 is used after login for data transfer. Now, I use 2121 for external ports because it's not a common port. That was for security reasons. Okay, that's it for the prerequisites. Head over to the FileZilla website and download FileZilla Server. For the most part, you can just keep the default settings and hit next. You will have to set a password. I just set it as 123. Finally, just press install. Onto the server configuration. Here you can just put in the password to log into the admin panel. Go up to the server tab, hit configure, and here's all the configuration settings. I'm going to add a remote user to my server. I am also specifying a password. So the virtual path is what the user sees in the browser. The native path is the folder they have access to. The virtual path can be anything you want, but the native path must exist. Next, go to server configuration and put in ports that we specified earlier. For the hostname, you can just use that hostname you set up on noip.com and test the settings. Everything seems to be going good. Now, the ultimate test. I'm going to connect to my FTP from outside my home network. I installed CX File Explorer on my phone. Now, the setup is quite simple. When you configure a server in the app, just simply put in that hostname, the username you created in FileZilla, and the password. Of course, don't forget the port, and that's it. As you can see, I'm connected to my home network from outside. Now, the changes are bi-directional, meaning that if a user deletes a file, it will delete it from your computer. And that was a setting in FileZilla Server. For each user, you can select read-only or read and write permission. Here are some basic security tips when working with FTPs. Use FTPS only. It prevents unencrypted logins and encrypts credentials and file transfers. Use a strong custom port for control. Consider using an obscure port for FTP like 2121. It helps reduce automated scan attempts. Use strong user credentials. Avoid default usernames like admin or FTP. Use complex long passwords. Only enable 1 to 2 specific users and not system user or general access. Restrict user access to specific folders. Set a home directory. Disable file, upload, and delete unless necessary. Enable read-only if applicable. Never allow access to system or program directories. Disable anonymous access. Make sure anonymous login is disabled. This is default in FileZilla. Just confirm under user settings. Configure firewall and router tightly. Forward only to your server's static LAN IP. Lock down the firewall to allow connections only from specific countries or IPs. If possible, use GeoIP filtering. Enable IP bands and connection limits. Enable max connections per IP, max login attempts before ban, and set the auto IP ban timeout. Disable unused protocols. Ensure plain FTP is fully disabled and don't use SSH or SFTP unless you've configured it properly and securely. Keep an eye on logs and watch out for suspicious IPs, frequent failed logins, and unknown client commands. Switch to SFTP if possible. It uses one port, typically 22, and is more firewall NAT friendly. It's considered more secure than FTPS, and tools like OpenSSH for Windows support it. And that's it, we're done. I've given you all the tips and tools you need to set up your own FTP server at home and connect to it remotely. Thanks for watching.